Hello. Today we're going to talk about junior developers and AI. I think the biggest question in everyone's mind is, how does AI impact a junior developer? Do we still need junior developers? What do junior developers do on teams now that AI can kind of take some of the work that maybe a junior developer would do? If I'm a junior developer, I may be looking at this kind of wondering, yeah, actually, how do I kind of differentiate myself? I think the most obvious thing that people might think about when they think about juniors and AI is really ChatGPT. ChatGPT can really answer a lot of different questions about how to build something. So for example, generate me a component that I can use for a login form in Next.js using Tailwind. Great, and after just a little while, it actually gives me a login form component. Let's actually see what that looks like. Great, so I just added this to an existing page, and you can actually see it's a pretty nice looking form component that's just developed right away. It just fits in the page really well, and it looks great. So this is really like the first thing. Wow, we have this really amazing ability to create components just by asking for them. The other thing that's sort of on the horizon is this idea of GitHub Copilots. You can actually just open a PR on GitHub, and it will actually go through the work of generating some PR, changing the code in your repository to be able to enact some change. So, you know, when you think about these sorts of changes, it's really a bigger question. Do we still need junior developers? My take on this is really like companies do still need junior developers. The world is really changing, but at the end of the day, companies still need junior developers. So why do I say this? First, like AI enables everyone to be able to do more. Competitors, companies, everyone's going to be able to do a lot more because of AI. If you think about like game design, Unity, these big game engines, they've actually created these like amazing tools that allow any game to ship across multiple different platforms. There's a lot of these sort of technologies that really enable a company that was only previously able to do something very kind of like small, now they're able to do a lot more, right? And every game company is able to do that. So if you're able to compete in that market, you really need to be releasing on multiple platforms because that gives you more opportunities. So what AI is going to do is what it's already doing is it enables senior developers, developers that understand how to utilize it, they're able to be more productive. I'm able to use ChatGPT to give me something really quick, and then I'm able to like iterate on it quite quickly because of my experience. But if everyone's doing that, you're going to see a lot more competition across the market with different companies doing more. The second really big reason that companies still need junior developers is that companies struggle to use AI. Many people aren't adopting this technology. This is still very early stage, and it's going to take years before people really feel comfortable with it. If we think about like front-end developers, Gmail was really the first application that used a single-page application on the front end. That changed how you built apps. Previously, there were like web pages, but now you've got these massive applications that can do a lot on a web page. That wasn't really possible before, and it changed that entire industry. There was a long period of time where it was hard to hire and get a web developer, but now a lot of the people coming out of a university, the people coming out of boot camps, they actually come with a lot of this knowledge kind of as their base set of knowledge, right? They are kind of like native to this space. And so actually a lot of times you'll get much better junior developers that know a lot about how React works than some of the senior developers, right? And they don't have the deep expertise, but they certainly have like the native knowledge of like what it is and how it works. So the same thing's true of AI. You have a lot of these developers who are kind of like developing their skill set right now. They're learning. And what are they learning? They're learning how AI can help them code. And so they're going to be way better at teaching your company how to code with AI than a lot of your senior developers. And then really the final reason why we're still going to need junior developers at all these companies is that we're going to be creating a lot of like AI tech debt. Generation of code has been something that's kind of always existed. You've got WYSIWYG editors. AI is now just another tool for being able to generate code, right? But there's going to be tech debt as a result of that. There's three types of tech debt that I can see. The first is really that we're going to need to be training models on our code bases. So if you think about how much work there is to sort of develop a new code base, you're actually needing to add model training on top of that, right? So if you decide, hey, we're going to make a major shift in direction, we're going to change our code base, now these trained models need to be completely reworked and retrained. That's a lot of debt that you've sort of incurred that you're going to have to basically just get rid of or figure out ways to retune. So it's just sort of like a sunken cost. The second kind of like major piece of tech debt is really this like spaghetti features. And it's like spaghetti code. The idea is like you have this generated code that doesn't know the context of how your application is built. If you did a really bad job training your model, or if that code was sort of generated and just kind of pasted in, it may not actually match the style, the understanding, the depth of knowledge of the rest of your application. And like while AI can do a lot of things, there's a lot of different things that you may want your code to do. You may want it to run really, really quickly. You may want it to be very extensible. You may actually want it to be very readable. You may want it to be low on its memory usage or use storage in such a way that it can run on very basic devices, IoT. There's a lot of different constraints that you may have over the same piece of code. There isn't really like a one size fits all. And so when we develop these features using AI, you need to bake that in. And if you don't do a good job baking that in, you end up with these sort of spaghetti features, these features that aren't really developed in an intended way for your application. And then the kind of like final piece of this is like really when you think about like the tech debt, you may actually end up starting over because it's sort of overwhelming. AI applications and this like kind of code generation, it's generated largely based off of like text, right? How I generated this Tailwind form component, I generated it based on a single line of text. It's much more complicated for you to take a large section of code and use that to dictate how some application should be built. It's a lot harder to direct. It's a lot harder to iterate on. And so when we really get into like product iterations where we want to change something in a very holistic way across our entire code base, it becomes almost easier in a way to just start over. But the challenge of starting over is that now you've lost a lot of these experience learnings. You've lost a lot of the tuning that you've done. And so like AI makes it this really difficult challenge in that like starting over is easier, but it's also harder to train in the things that you've learned. And so we're going to be in this like sort of like weird space here where you don't want your product to be locked into some solution. But at the same time, there's a bit of lock-in that you sort of have to have if you're mostly relying on AI to develop your application. And that's going to limit how much your product can evolve and how much your product can change, unless you're willing to take the hit and just completely rebuild your application from scratch every time you make a major product shift. In order to be able to make an application that's more flexible, you really need a junior developer that can help with sort of managing this tech debt. Somebody who can actually sort of like think through how the code is evolving. That doesn't necessarily even need to be a senior person. It just needs to be somebody who can understand the direction that the code needs to be generated in, and somebody to just kind of like watch what's happening, right? You just need more hands, not necessarily experienced hands. So I've got a few recommendations for junior developers kind of in this new space. I think for starters, there's kind of the base thing that I basically tell all junior developers is just ask questions and stay curious. If you're somebody who doesn't have deep experience, that doesn't mean that you're not helpful. You're most helpful by kind of like challenging how things are being done, asking questions that maybe nobody else would ask. Those questions and that curiosity can sometimes lead teams to see things that they wouldn't otherwise see. That's a really big benefit to any team. The second one is really like use your advantage. Your advantage is you're just learning, right? All of this is new to you. AI tools are also very new. And because you're sort of learning right now, you can really take advantage of that kind of learning time to also pull in this sort of AI knowledge, right? You can experiment with it and you can really develop an understanding that nobody else has. And then third is really just work on like sort of empathy and communication. AI needs a lot of empathy for you to be able to communicate to it. But people also don't really know how to kind of have a conversation with AI, and they'd rather have a conversation with a person. If you're able to be that sort of conduit between somebody who's really intelligent about product or really intelligent about thinking about software, and you're able to be that conduit of communication between them and an AI, that's an immediately a great place to be. You can be very helpful, and you can learn a lot from that person because they'll sort of see you as this really useful, helping person that they want to invest in because they're able to get so much more from you. So in summary, I think we really do still need junior developers. There's not really a way around it. Sure, we're bringing in AI. Sure, we've got a lot of great tools, but there's nothing really replacing the need to have these junior people on our teams. Companies are going to need them. And if you're a junior, there's still a really great place out there for you. You just have to find how to market yourself. If you follow the recommendations I've given, I think you'll be in a much better place. Thanks for tuning in. If there's any more information that you'd like to hear about AI, you can likely find a lot of it on our website, Stable Discussion. We have a publication there where we publish articles, as well as a podcast where me and my co-host Della often talk about AI and the changes happening. We're going to be releasing a new one this coming week, so stay tuned for that. And thanks so much.